In this problem, we're looking at how to build an ammeter using a galvanometer. So a galvanometer is sort of a generic device that will tell you whether or not current is flowing through it as a needle deflects against a scale. This galvanometer has a pretty large internal resistance, so it's not going to make the best ammeter in the world, but we can at least get into the principle of how it works. It has an internal resistance of 1.8 ohms. Now, physically, that's the resistance of the coil of wire inside the galvanometer, but we model it as a resistanceless galvanometer in series with an internal resistance. And we're told that when 0.02 amps flows through this galvanometer, it reaches the full deflection on the scale. Now, to use a galvanometer as an ammeter, you connect it in parallel with the resistance that's designed to control the deflection on that galvanometer. And in this case, what we want to do, if we look at part B here, is compute that resistance that's required to make it so we get full deflection on the galvanometer when there's 0.1 amps passing through this ammeter circuit. We'll back up and start with part A. I want the voltage drop over the ammeter when the galvanometer reaches full deflection. So again, this happens when there's 0.02 amps flowing through the galvanometer branch of the ammeter circuit. And the potential difference across this is just given by Ohm's law. So V equals IR. My current is 0.02 amps. My internal resistance was 1.8 ohms. And I get a potential difference of 0.036 volts. In part B, we want to find that resistance, capital R, that we put in parallel with the galvanometer branch so that this maximum deflection is achieved when there's 0.1 amps total current running through the ammeter circuit. Well, if there's 0.1 amps total current, then I immediately know how much is running through the upper branch, through that capital R. And it's just 0.1 amps for the total current minus the amount that went down the lower branch, which was 0.02. And this gives me 0.08 amps running through that upper branch. Well, now I have the potential difference across that big R. That's the same as the potential difference across the lower branch. That's 0.036 volts, and I have the total current running through that branch, 0.08 amps, so I can figure out what capital R is required to make this happen. Again, we state Ohm's law, V equals IR for this upper branch, and my V, my potential difference across this resistor, is 0.036 volts. My current is known to be 0.08 amps, and big R is the only unknown here, so when I solve for big R, I get 0.45 ohms. So we got the job done on designing this ammeter the way we wanted to, and given a galvanometer that had this 1.8 ohm internal resistance. But I will emphasize that this is a pretty bad ammeter. Ordinarily, what you're trying to achieve is an ammeter that interferes with the circuit as little as possible. And in this case, we have 20% of the current running through the galvanometer branch and causing a 0.036 volt drop over the ammeter. In real life, you'd want a galvanometer with a smaller internal resistance to make it so you wouldn't change your circuit substantially by putting this thing in series. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.